You don't know how to freeze frame in CapCut PC. Yep, that's me. You're probably wondering how I ended up in this situation.
I can fix that.
All right, first things first. Open up CapCut and start a new project. Then, in the top left, make sure you're in the Media tab, and then click Import. Navigate to where your content is at, click it, and then click Open. It'll be added into this bin. Click and drag your content onto the timeline. And for reference, this is just the video of me doing a quick roll. And then at this point, you want to make sure that your clip is actually selected. So you see how I have this white outline on my clip? If I click into the timeline, you see how it's not highlighted. You want to click it, make sure it's highlighted, and then click and drag your playhead to the point in time where you want to actually freeze the frame. And then on top of your timeline, you want to click this freeze button, and it'll create a clip of that frame for an extended period of time. And you can actually click the end of that clip and make it shorter so you have a shorter freeze frame, or make it longer so you have a longer freeze frame. So if I just keep it like this and start my clip over, it'll freeze the frame right there, and then it'll continue at the end of it. Another cool thing that you can do with freeze frame is to leave one of your frozen clones behind, or to walk into one of your frozen clones. So to do that, you go over here and make sure that main track magnet is turned on, and then make sure that auto snapping is turned on. Then drag your content onto the timeline. And for reference, this is just a video of me walking across my room. Then you want to grab your playhead and go to the point where you want to leave a clone behind. So I'm going to leave a clone behind right about here. Then on the top of your timeline, click freeze, and it'll stretch out that frame into a longer duration. Then you want to move that clip to the video track above your current one and make sure it's in line with the playhead. You see how the playhead is highlighted blue right now? That means it's in line with it. If it's white, then it's not. So make sure it's in line, because you want the frame to be in the exact same spot it was before. So drop it there and then lengthen out that clip all the way to the end of your previous video clip. Now in the top right, making sure that you have this video clip selected, you want to click on the video tab and then the cutout tab. Then click auto cutout so it will remove the background. Then when you play your video, you see it leaves behind your clone. Now, if you want to walk into the clone, you need to move your playhead to the point where you want to walk into it. So let's see, I walk right out of it at that point. So let's walk into it right here. And then you stop your playhead right there. Make sure you select your video clip, like your original video clip, not the freeze. And then click on freeze, and it'll make another freeze clip. But you want to take this one and you want to move it behind your playhead. So make sure it's still in line, but make sure it's behind it. And then make sure the duration of this goes to the beginning of your video, or the beginning of the clip that you started walking. Then you want to go to the top right, make sure you're in the video tab, then click cutout, then click auto cutout when you're selected on this freeze clip, and then it'll remove the background. Then when you go to the beginning of your video and press play, you'll actually see that you have your frozen clone right there. Please check out some of my other videos and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching. Peace.